Chander and Dr. Praveen from Madras Medical College on cervical lymphadenopathy.
I hope all the presenters are aware of their case schedule. So moment the case presenter finishes his case, please come and upload your presentation so that you can save time on. Over to the faculty. Professor Ramasubramaniam sir, Professor Rekha madam, Dorai sir and Dr. Jyothivel sir to come up to the stage please.
Dear audience, PGs, you can ask any questions to the examiners. Any difficulties, any doubt is there, you can directly, you can ask. Don't hesitate. Thank you.
Good morning to respected professors and my dear colleagues. I'm here to present a case of tuberculous lymphadenitis. Mr. X, 26-year-old, a student residing in Arelur, presented with cheek complaints of swelling over the left side of the neck for the past 6 months. History of presenting illness. The patient was apparently normal 6 months back. Then he developed, incidentally noticed a swelling over the left side of the neck. It was initially small in size and progressed to the present size. It is associated with the pain for the past 20 days, which is dull aching pain, intermittent, non-radiating, no aggravating or relieving factors. These are the past histories, positive histories. There are no history of cough, hemoptysis, loss of weight, loss of appetite, evening rise of temperature, fever, and no history of any abdominal pain, distension, jaundice, no history of dysphagia or dysphagia. Personal history and family history are insignificant. No history of any contact with the tuberculosis in the family members or in the vicinity of the neighborhood. We are proceeding with general examination.
After obtaining consent, patient has been examined under broad daylight. On a general examination, patient is general condition is fair, no positive findings, not pale, no pedal edema, no sinus clubbing. The vitals were stable. On local examination of neck, a swelling of size 5 cross 4 centimeter present over the lateral aspect of the left side of the neck. It is in the level 3 region. It is oval in shape. Surface appears to be smooth. The skin of the swelling is apparently normal. No sinus, cast, dilated veins are discharged present from the swelling. No, the swelling is not in the cervical region on the opposite side. Other inguinal node region like axilla and inguinal region, no swelling is noted. Supraclavicular force are free. Examination of the oral cavity, ear, nose, scalp and thorax were normal. No positive findings are present. On palpation, the swelling is not warm, not tender. A swelling of size approximately, swelling of size 5 cross 4 centimeter present over the left side of the neck, lateral aspect, extending, upper border extending 2 centimeter from the angle of the mandible, lower border extending 4 centimeter above the left sternoclavicular joint, middle border extending 4 centimeter lateral to the midline, and lateral border 1 centimeter medial anterior to the posterior border of left sternocleidomastoid muscle. The swelling is oval in shape and surface is nodular on palpation. It is firm in consistency. Skin is pinchable. Swelling is mobile in all directions. No fixity through skin and deeper structures. No abnormal pulsation present over the swelling. No scar sinus discharge. Examination of the opposite side is normal. Examination of axilla and inguinal node normal, other systems were normal. On examination, systemic examination, CVS is normal, no murmur, RS, respiratory system, bilateral arrangement present, no added sounds, perabdomen, no organomegaly was present, spine and cranium normal. Moving on to diagnosis, probably it is a case of left cervical lymphadenopathy of benign etiology, probably tuberculous etiology.
Now, what is the plane of the swelling?
The plane is subcutaneous.
But you said it's a lymph node in your diagnosis. So you expect the lymph node to be subcutaneous?
It may present.
Maybe you have subcutaneous lymph nodes in the neck.
It may present.
Okay, I'll leave it.
session. You know, it's not a teaching session. That's the question, and it's for the other examiners to judge.
Doctor, it is subcutaneous. Plane of the swelling, you are telling as a subcutaneous. What about the diagnosis is cervical lymph adenitis? If you are telling as a subcutaneous, same thing, you have to tell some more finding also. Normally, what is the plane of the lymph node?
Deep to deep
cervical fascia. Then why it is subcutaneous here? What is the test you have done? So a lot of the things you have not mentioned, and you drag on to a lot of other examination and all. Other examination is related to your differential diagnosis only.
Sir, I have tested for a skin fixity. Skin is pinchable. We have tested for a muscle fixity. The swelling appears prominent on extending the contracting the left sternum mastoid. So it is probably a subcutaneous swelling.
So you suspect it's a cervical lymphadenitis.
Cervical lymphadenitis.
Whether it's a swelling is a fluctuation.
It's the fluctuation
positive?
Non-fluctuant, sir.
Fluctuating positive or not? You have not mentioned about that.
Fluctuation says so negative.
Because you said it is a subcutaneous, if it is a fluctuating, could be, what is your diagnosis could
cold
be?
Cold abscess.
Yes, fluctuating swelling.
Cold abscess.
Could be in a cold abscess also, where the skin will be pinchable. What are the stages of tuberculosis lymphadenitis?
Sir, lymphadenitis, stage of lymphadenitis, stage of peritonitis, with cold abscess, stage of cold abscess, callus had abscess, sinus formation.
Yes. When the cold abscess will be fixing to the skin? When?
Callus had abscess.
So it could be in a cold abscess also the reason, but you are not tested for a fluctuation.
You said you examined the neck. What are the other nodes that you looked for?
Other levels of nodes you have looked, ma'am.
You want to say anatomically or you want to talk in terms of levels?
We'll talk. Level of the nodes are examined. Level 1.
Anatomical,
axillary and inguinal nodes.
Clinically, always talk anatomical group of lymph nodes. What are the nodes you looked for?
Axillary, inguinal.
I said neck.
Neck, ma'am. Occipital,
posterior triangle. Pre-auricular, post-auricular and occipital nodes are being examined. Posterior triangle nodes examined.
Is that how you classify nodes? Yeah.
Submental, submandibular, upper jugular, middle jugular, lower jugular, jugulodigastric, sir.
Anatomically, how you diagnose? You stage level 1 A, B, what is level 2?
Level 1 A is submental, sir. Level 1 B is submandibular. Level 2 is from base of skull to hyoid bone. It is upper in the upper jugular. Upper jugular. Jugular along the jugular vein, upper jugular vein.
Is there any upper jugular?
Jugulodigastric.
What is that? There is no upper jugular lymph node. Because for making a diagnosis, you should know about the groups of lymph nodes. Not the level and all is somewhat different in other situations. Here you are making a diagnosis of a lymph node.
Are you familiar with something called as a Waldeyer's ring?
Yes, Waldeyer's.
Can you explain that?
There's two ring, inner ring and outer ring. Inner ring consists of palatine tonsils, adenoids.
What is?
Inner ring consists of inner ring consists of fascial tonsils, lingual tonsil, tubal tonsil, and adenoids. Outer ring consists of submental, submandibular, pre-auricular, post-auricular, and occipital.
That's what we were asking for earlier.
Okay. What are the findings in favor of tuberculosis? Science. Clinical signs.
You said the diagnosis was TB, right? What makes you say you think it is tuberculosis?
Young age, most commonly in India, it is most common.
Clinical signs.
Yeah, swelling in the neck, which is its firm in consistency, non-tender, not warm.
Sign. What do you elicit? Say that it is tuberculosis.
It's firm in consistency, mobile, not fixed to skin or deeper structures. It's nodal or surface.
Stage 3 make it tuberculosis.
Mating of lymph nodes. Mated lymph nodes.
Are they mated?
No, you are not told about any specific signs.
You must justify your genital impression with signs.
See, there are certain signs for tuberculosis, there are certain signs for malignant lymph node,
yes, sir.
Secondary lymph node and all.
Yes, sir.
So you have to specify, because of this finding, I am telling it as a tuberculosis.
Yes, sir.
That should be a self-explanatory.
Lymph nodes are, it's a discrete lymph nodes, are not mated, but yes.
Can discrete. We say that you are not able to come to a
conclusion, yes,
about the nature of the pathology?
Then you have to
come to that conclusion now?
Yes, sir.
Then
yes.
You have to put a differential diagnosis.
You have to put a different diagnosis. Yes.
So to say, I am not able to come to a conclusion, so I will do, sir.
So you must, if you are not able to come to a clear conclusion, with the help of your signs that you elicited, you must say that very honestly that you are not able to. And I'm sure all the examiners might agree with you.
Yes, sir.
Because that's the same state they will be in.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now that you say that there is going to be there could be a differential diagnosis, what do you think are the differential diagnoses in this case?
Probably first and second like that you should tell.
Sir, only one system of node involved. Next.
Yes, very good.
Non-specific lymphadenitis. Lymphoma will be my last diagnosis, sir.
Non-specific?
No. Tell.
You say 1, 2, 3.
You tell what is the diagnosis because of these findings.
Non-specific lymphadenitis.
You think the non-specific?
First one.
You think there is non-specific?
Such a big node, you said. How can it be a non-specific? Where is the non-specific lymph nodes commonly seen? It's a posterior triangle, no?
Posterior triangle.
Tuberculous lymphadenitis. Tuberculous lymphadenitis.
Discrete. You told discrete nodes. What is how many lymph nodes you have palpated? Only a single node.
Single nodes.
You said this mass was 5 × 4 and had a nodular surface. You think all of it is one mass or it's?
It is a nodular surface, so probably a matted node may be present.
When you say matting, what do you understand from that? When does a group of node become matted?
When there is periodinitis, it usually adheres to one another.
So you think this is in that stage?
Yes, ma'am. So the surface nodular on palpation. Clinically.
What do you want to do for this patient now?
No, I want to identify the primary from where it has come. So I would like to take a chest x-ray, blood investigation, routine blood investigations to look for any lymphocytosis and check for anemic status of the patient. Then I'll take an chest x-ray to look for a pulmonary.
Sorry to interrupt. In an examination of a short case, considering that this is a scenario in the examination, when they ask you what will you, how will you investigate, then you must say that apart from doing general investigations, I would like to do this investigation to confirm the diagnosis. So in this case, what, because this is a short case, not much time. We can't be going on talking to you. There's no time for that. We need to judge you. So what is the diagnostic test that you will do to confirm the diagnosis?
UOG guide, FNAC, I will take, sir.
FNAC?
We'll
do FNAC, sir.
FNAC.
Yeah.
FNAC is inconclusive.
Excisional biopsy.
Open biopsy.
Excision biopsy you'll do. You will not do anything else.
Non-invasive procedure, CT, neck, thorax, I will take.
Confirm the diagnosis. Tissue diagnosis.
Confirm the diagnosis, doctor.
We'll go with
the timekeeper has said, which means your fate is going to decide in the next 2 minutes.
2 minutes, yeah.
Take a excision biopsy, sir. Go with the excision biopsy.
You have a 5 to 4 cm mass. Excision biopsy?
Incision biopsy.
If it's tuberculosis, what other investigations would be considered?
Sputum.
By after excision, how will you confirm this is a with a specimen? How will you confirm it is a tuberculosis?
So we can send it for histopathology and gene expert.
Histopathology on the table. How will you confirm?
On the table.
Caseation will be present on examination. It is over yellowish granular tissue.
Sir, specimen in the hand. How do you have a clue that it is tuberculosis?
The lymph nodes will be matted and caseating material will be present in the
caseation will be caseation will be there.
Histopathology. On microscopy, what will you see?
Microscopy, we see a granuloma surrounded by a Langerhans giant cells, epithelioids, and plasma cells.
Central caseation.
There will be a central caseation surrounding by a epithelioid cells and okay. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.